Hey guys, so in my last video I had mentioned I was going to be doing a makeup haul to show you all of the new palettes that I had gotten recently. So that's what I'm going to be doing today, and it's actually going to be sort of a two-for-one video because I felt like everything I was going to be showing you would be a really great gift idea, that I wanted to add a couple other palettes that I've had for a little while but I still love them that I think would make great gifts as well. So I'm going to go ahead and start off with the new stuff first, and all of the palettes that I'm going to be showing you are available at Ulta or Ulta.com, which is where I got most of them. So starting off with the Urban Decay Naked on the Run palette, I did not think I was going to get this just because there's so many different Naked products that they have, but I'm actually really, really happy with this one. It has two matte shadows, three shimmery ones, and then the highlight one is kind of a mix in between. It's not matte, but it does definitely have some sheen to it. I would say out of all of the colors, the highlight one is the one that I like the least, but everything else in here I love, especially this light pink shadow. It's what I'm wearing on the center of my lids right now, and I've been wearing it every single day. This is one that I actually feel like is worth the money, and I've been enjoying it quite a bit. I also picked out the IT Cosmetics Naturally Pretty Celebration palette. So you guys know that last time I picked up just the regular Naturally Pretty palette and I was not going to get this one, but I couldn't resist. This is the limited edition one for holiday, and I think that I'll actually like the colors in this one maybe a little bit better. I didn't think that I would, but looking at it, you know, in person, I think that I'll enjoy it. So that's what it looks like. And I think that this is such a cute one for the holidays because all of the names are kind of holiday themed. Now, this is the only one that I have not tried yet, but I do think that I will really like it. And just looking at the colors, I think that it's going to be great. But I think that this would be such an awesome gift because it is probably the only one that I'm going to show you that's actually holiday themed. I do like my regular Naturally Pretty palette. This one's just, you know, a little bit more special because it is for the holidays. It's limited edition, and I think that would be a great gift. I can't wait to try that one out. The next one is probably the best value as far as how many full-size items that you get, and this one is an Ulta exclusive. So this is the Too Faced Modern Mattes collection. It comes with this eyeshadow palette, a full-size Better Than Sex mascara, which I've been dying to try, and also a full-size bulletproof eyeliner smudge stick thing. So this one I've actually only tried once, so I can't tell you for sure if I love it, but I did like the look that I came up with when I tried it. So here's what the palette looks like. And when I saw this online, I did not know it was going to be coming with full-size items, especially for the price that it was. So those are the colors. As you can see, it comes with a decent range from light to dark. However, I do want to mention that this palette is very cool toned. So if you're someone that likes warmer shadows, you will need to add something. If you love cool tones, then this is great for you. I personally like to mix and match, but I do tend to lean more towards warmer colors. I mean, I did like the look that I came up with when I tried it, but it was different for me to use so many cool tones. And also, Too Faced shadows for me can be very difficult to blend, and because they're matte, I feel like it makes it even worse. Not a horrible palette, but just something that's not as easy as some of the other ones that I have. So I'm gonna continue to play with that, and hopefully I'll like it a little bit better. And then the last new palette that I got is from Smashbox. It's their Double Exposure palette. So this is the new one. You guys know that I have the Full Exposure palette and I really like it, so I want to try out this one as well. Now, if you're someone that doesn't have a lot of eyeshadows, or if you're buying for someone that doesn't have a lot of eyeshadows, I would stick to the regular Full Exposure palette just because this one is not quite as versatile. It doesn't have as many neutrals, but I think that this is a great companion to the Full Exposure palette. I know a lot of people already have that one. It's basically got a silver and a black, and then this side's all cool, and then this side is some warmer shades. And I've been absolutely loving these two right here. Again, what I have on my lids right now, I've been wearing it pretty much every single day, and I'm obsessed. I haven't tried all of the colors yet, pretty much just the warm ones, but I do like it a lot. I don't know, for some reason with these Smashbox palettes, I tend to favor like one or two shadows and then I just can't stop using them. I'll show you my Full Exposure one in a second. But I think this would be a nice holiday gift. I can see a lot of people doing some New Year's looks and things like that. I want to do a tutorial on the eye look that I'm wearing right now just because I've been obsessed with it. And again, mostly it is these two shadows right here. So I do really like that. It comes with a double-ended brush as well as a mini mascara, so that's what the brush looks like. And it is a different brush than the regular Full Exposure palette, so if you already have that one, don't worry about getting the same brush because it's a different one. So those are all of the new palettes that I had gotten, and I think any of those would be really great gifts, but I didn't want to only mention those and not mention some of my other favorites that I think would be nice to give as well. So first up, the Lorac Pro 2 palette. Did not think I was gonna like this because, like I mentioned, I don't normally like such cool colors, but I get way more use out of this one than my original Lorac Pro. So that's what that looks like. It was very surprising to me because I when I look at this, I'm not attracted to the colors, but just every look that I've tried with this, I've loved. I've mostly just been sticking with this corner over here and then some of the ones down here. I haven't really tried the plum, navy, charcoal, or any of those types of colors, but everything that I have tried so far, I do really like. And for some reason, I feel like this palette isn't as powdery as my original Lorac Pro, which was really the only downfall for me with the Lorac Pro, is that it was just so powdery and I felt like the shadows got everywhere. This one doesn't seem quite as bad, so I'm happy with that as well. And when you get this, it comes with a little deluxe sample size of their eye primer as well. So I think that that would be a great gift. And again, it's a nice palette to accompany if somebody already has the Lorac Pro. I also really recommend just the original Smashbox Full Exposure palette. I've had this for a while and I use it quite frequently, especially one of the colors in here. So that's what it looks like. As you can see, it's more of just your basic neutrals. The entire bottom row is matte shades and the entire top row are shimmery, sparkly shades. And then this is the color that I use all the time. As you can see, it's got a pretty decent dent in there compared to the other shadows. I love this color. I would wear this color pretty much every day. It's something that you could just wear by itself, blend it out, and it looks really beautiful. So I think that this is so great. I wish that they had this in just a single shadow. I would definitely buy it. But then I also like this color as like a transition, and I use this for my highlight. It's just a good basic neutrals palette. So really like that one. And it's a little bit different, a little bit more special than your typical neutral, because there are some really sparkly shadows in here. So that could be nice for the holidays or for New Year's and things like that. So really, really like that. And I'm also wearing this eyeshadow palette. I mix a lot of palettes today, and that's what I've been doing lately. But I'm using this color as my base shadow all over my lid, and then I have this as my highlight. So I mixed both of the palettes together and a little bit of the Naked on the Run. And then the last two palettes that I wanted to mention as recommendations have actually been out for a while, but I didn't want to do like a top palettes video without mentioning them because they are a couple of my favorites. They are both warm palettes and they're also both permanent, so even though they've been out for a little bit, you can still get them. So first up is the Lorac Unzipped palette, and I've had this for a while, but I don't think I've talked to you guys about it that much. I would say out of all of the eyeshadow palettes that I have, this is my absolute favorite for a warm neutral eye. So that's what it looks like. Oh my gosh, I'm so sad right now. I went to go hold up the palette so I could show you, and I dropped it. My nail like dug into it. So there's like a huge chunk missing out of one of the matte shades now, which is sad because there's only four shades in there that are matte. All of the rest of them are shimmery, but that's the way it goes. Anyway, that's what the palette looks like. I would say out of all of the shades, Unbelievable, Unconditional, and Unbridled are my favorite, and those are the ones that I usually use from here. And then lastly, I don't feel like I can do a palette recommendation video without mentioning one of the Naked palettes. So this is my personal favorite. It's the Naked 3, which is the newest one, and of course it does have some warm shades in it. I do really like this palette, but I pretty much like all of the Naked palettes. They have so many different Naked products now. They've got Naked 1, 2, and 3, as well as Naked Basics and Naked Basics 2, and then all of the blush palettes and all kinds of crazy things. But I would say out of everything, this is probably my favorite. I like warmer shadows, and I also feel like I could wear any of the colors in this palette and still have it come out looking nice versus Naked 1 or Naked 2, where I kind of have to pick and choose which ones I'd use. So I really like this one. If you're going to be getting them for a gift for somebody, obviously you want to choose whatever one will complement their skin tone best or whichever one they don't have already. This one I use a little bit more evenly, and that's why I wanted to recommend it, but any of the Naked palettes I think would be a great choice. Everybody wants to get them, and I think overall they're a really great product. I love the Naked 3 and I love the Naked on the Run. I would say out of everything, those two are my favorites from Urban Decay. So those are all of my new palettes and my palette recommendations. As I mentioned before, all of these can be purchased at Ulta or Ulta.com. I will leave a list of all of the ones that I mentioned in this video in the info box below, and that's pretty much it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and that it was helpful for you, and I will talk to you very soon. Bye!